y equals bx plus a. The key holy grail in linear regression and in much of statistics is how to use data to determine the value of b and the value of a. So if you can do this with data, then we solve the problem of fitting the best line, and that's once again called linear regression. So I won't give you the derivation, but I'll give you the formula. Let's start with b. Assuming your data comes in pairs for x and y, as indicated here, then the formula for b might look really complex at first, but I promise you it isn't. Just in the calculation of the variance, you take the difference between x and the mean of x. But rather than squaring this as in the variance case, you now do a product with the same term for the y's. So important here in this notation, x bar is the mean of the xi's and y bar is the mean of the yi's. Previously, we would have called x bar mu, but now that we have two variables, you're going to use the bar notation. Let's go back and look at this formula here. When we computed the variance, you would have taken xi minus x bar with a square. But here we're taking the product of xi minus x bar multiplied with the y direction of the same thing. So it's similar to computing a variance. The last thing we'll do is normalize this thing. Before, we often normalize with n, but now we're going to normalize with something else. We normalize with a term that very much reminds us of the variance.